Thank you, James. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Madison Square Garden. The Toronto Maple Leafs and the New York Rangers, as the Maple Leafs have a firm grip on a playoff spot. The Rangers still in a dogfight there in Vancouver.
Well, they certainly are. The pressure is certainly on John Tortorella, their head coach, and after losing on Monday night at the ACC against the Leafs, a real tightly contested hockey game. This should be a good one here. But what I liked in that hockey game was the defensive matchup. Jay McClemon at center ice and Leo Komarov, who did an outstanding job really getting the kitchen of Callahan, really going after Rick Nash, and that'll be it again tonight. But they've got a newest member on the left side. It won't be Grabowski. It'll be Hamilton with McClemon and Komarov on the defensive side of it.
Yeah, Ryan Hamilton, the captain this season of the Toronto Marlies of the American Hockey League, is in for Toronto. Joel Colburn is out, and the Maple Leafs start Bozak along with Kessel and Van Riemsdyk, and the line of Stepan, Nash, and Callahan go to work for New York. Stepan and Nash between them have 25 of the Rangers' last 50 goals. And Nash sends that down to James Reimer, who will quickly pounce on that.
Well, for James Reimer, when you're on the road, you don't have to put on a show. And that's just an easy play. You settle things down, and you make sure you get that whistle. Don't play it off to the side if you're, you know, if you're not having that communication with your defenseman. You don't want to get on your heels early on in the game. Interesting that Nash just fired that right on net, right off the hop like that from center ice.
Dion Phaneuf is out there for Toronto on his 28th birthday against Nash. Both his goals on Monday were scored with Phaneuf off the ice for Toronto. And a big hit by Callahan on Carl Gunnarsson. Now Ryan Hamilton, wearing number 48, works in for Toronto and shoots. He whistled that through traffic. Hamilton hasn't scored in 10 career NHL games, having a good year for the Toronto Marlies with 30 goals in 56 games in the AHL. Henrik Lundqvist. Close for Matt Zuccarello. That bounced off his skate, and the puck loose behind the Rangers goal. Picked up and wounded ahead slowly by Anton Stroman. He was bumped by Van Riemsdyk. And Jay McClemon sends it back down to the Ranger line. Tony Franson, hard pass ahead to Kessel. Phil Kessel in, shoots in his short side. And back in behind the Ranger goal, Ryan McDonough has it. He got tied up there by Kessel. And Van Riemsdyk digging for it. Van Riemsdyk's got 50 friends and family here tonight. He's from Middletown, New Jersey, about an hour and a half from Manhattan.
Well, Van Riemsdyk had a chance in neutral zone, Gord, to really hammer Anton Stralman, and he just avoided that hit. It would have been a major collision. But good quick up pass by the Maple Leafs and springing Kessel, who fires it wide to the glove side.
Dan Girardi back for it. His longtime defense partner Mark Stahl still out after suffering an eye injury. Skated today for the second consecutive day. But McCarthy with a drive, and Lundqvist the save on him. And a good early pace here in New York. There's Derek Brassard, one of the three players acquired at the deadline. Sends it back in front. Great chance for Haglund. Shut down short side by Reimer. And Nazem Kadri slides that just out of the zone for Toronto to Clark MacArthur.
Yeah, Randy Carlyle communicating from the bench to get that puck in deep right there. But a good play by Reimer just to get that right pad snug against the post.
Kadri played fewer than 13 minutes on Monday night. There, that's the fewest minutes he's played in the game since opening night of the season. Long shot by Fraser McLaren, gloved by Henrik Lundqvist. He'll hang on.
Well, this line was obviously brilliant in the win on Monday night, and here's a golden chance here for Kessel. He tries to go to the glove side. Didn't look like there was much room when he skated over here to the bench, though. It's a quick change of the twig right there. And you know, it's finding a little magic in another one, but he certainly was frustrated coming off to the bench. That's a golden opportunity early. Had a little bit of room too, Gord, didn't he, to maybe step in a little bit and maybe disguise that shot a little bit. It looked like the goaltender Lundqvist read that all the way and smothered that short side anyway, even if he did hit the net.
Mark Fraser off the faceoff, win by Toronto, plays with a cross, and Tony Franson with a drive. Lundqvist steers that away. And Mikhail Grabowski, who won that draw, broke his stick on the play. And the puck brought across the line by John Moore, but the play is offside. Tonight's game plan is brought to you by Tim Hortons, our Canada, our coffee.
Well, we know that Randy Carlyle is one of the great matchup coaches in the NHL. So Jay McClement's line, he's so good defensively. It's going to be shutdown time on the Stephon line and Rick Nash, of course. And then when you talk about the Rangers and Girardi, you talk about clearing the crease. They got to do a better job of protecting goaltender Henrik Lundqvist. I would imagine a large percentage of the goals going in on the New York Rangers scored are goals inside 10 feet.
John Torella identified that prior to this game. Lundqvist allowed four against Toronto on Monday night. Here is the third time this season he's allowed more than three goals in a start.
And the backbreaker certainly was right after the Rangers had scored to tie the game up.
39 seconds later, Kessel scored the winner. Enough to Komarov. Out there along with McClements and Hamilton. And the bouncing puck goes in for Steve Eminger. Plays that across to John Moore, acquired as part of that deal at St. Marion Gamrick, the Blue Jackets last week. Hamilton digs it out. He finds Tyler Bozak fresh off the bench. Back and goes to Franzen. Through the feet of Kessel, back he goes, and the long shot by Fraser goes off a leg, up and out of play.
Well, while in the offensive zone, even though the big line's on the ice for the New York Rangers, Jay McClement, the wily veteran, because it's in the offensive zone, he goes for a line change, and he gets Bozak on the ice. So trying to get a little pressure on the offensive side of it and put some pressure on Nash and Callahan in the defensive zone.
And now Bozak will step in for the draw. Only Claude Giroux of the Philadelphia Flyers has taken more faceoffs this year than Bozak, who's Toronto's best at 53%. He won that one. And now Brassard has it for New York. Brassard, Moore, and Ryan Clough all scored their Ranger debut last week against the Pittsburgh Penguins. As the trade deadline paid immediate dividends for New York. Mark Fraser goes back for it, being harassed there by Carl Hagelin. Chipped up by Van Riemsdyk, but that was broken up by Girard.
As it works out, Marion Gaborik had a goal and an assist in his debut for the Columbus Blue Jackets that are having a terrific year.
And Girardi steps up, the puck squeezed in behind him. Ryan McDonough plays it back in. Shots a 3-1 Toronto in the early going, no score in the first period. Kessel. Lost the handle, Clough comes in. And Ryan Clough, who didn't score this season for San Jose, that had two in that game against Pittsburgh. Plays it back to Strom, and the puck skipped away from him.
Kessel's having a tough time with those twigs early on. That was an easy outlet pass, and it was on the tape, and he fumbled around there, and it ended up going the other way.
Time for another new one. They might have to order another batch between periods. Michael Delzato in, fire, saved by Reimer, rebound loose in front, backhanded out by John Michael Lyle.
You might want to grab one of his sister Amanda's twigs.
They're hot.
As she represented the USA in their World Championship victory in Ottawa.
How about the year she had in college? 46 goals in 38 games. Here comes Kulman on the drive off the shoulder of Henrik Lundqvist and Nikolai Kulman. Heating up, he's got as many goals this season as he had all of last. After a tough start to the season, Mark Fraser sees that back in front to Clark MacArthur, that skipped away from him. And Clough sends that rip wide to Brad Richards. Fraser back forth to Franzen. And Cody Franzen spins back off the forecheck of Matt Zuccarello, who's back in the NHL after spending this season with Magnitogorsk of the KHL.
I think he comes back to the NHL a little more seasoned, in better condition, according to the New York Rangers, a little stronger. Obviously not a big guy. He's one of my little guys with gumption, Gord, but he's got some great instincts offensively.
He needs to be a little guy with production to stay, though, Derek.
Yes, he does, especially in the shootout.
Ryan O'Byrne has to retreat as Darryl Powell breaks in on him. How about Ryan O'Byrne scoring in his Maple Leafs debut on Monday night? That was his 301st NHL game. He scored five times in the first 300. Fraser McLaren, bumped there by Taylor Plank. Gets it out. And Grabowski finds Lyle. Hit off the bench of McLaren looking for Colton Orr. That bounced wide.
What a great pass there by John Michael Lyle finding the late man. Colton Orr just came off the bench on a line change.
Grabowski with McLaren and Orr. So Mikhail Grabowski played a season-low minutes total as well on Monday night. And the puck loose in the Rangers zone as Orr is digging for it. And Powell swings that across. Michael Delzato feeds that through the middle of the pass. Bounced away from Ryan Callahan. And he's bumped by Fanuf. Gunnarsson comes in to help out. The puck still loose behind the Toronto goal. Picked up by Callahan. Send him. Stefan just fanned on that. And Girardi steps up for New York. Finds Callahan. And Stefan battles for it. Gunnarsson poked that hit for Orr. He wasn't looking. And Nash played it back in for New York. Callahan feeds it back. McDonough even shoots. That was blocked. McDonough gets it back. Feeds it back in front through the feet of Nash. Girardi now plays it back. The Leafs are hemmed in here. Fourth line is on the ice against the Rangers top line. Callahan to Nash. Back to Girardi across the Stefan. Long wrist shot. That goes wide. Callahan back on it. Ryan Callahan walks up. Shoots. A paint off. An open wide. Chips like this usually result in a goal or a penalty. As the Leafs remain hemmed in, here's Nash with it. Back to McDonough. Cross to Girardi. Slides it down to Stefan. Nash in the high slot, calling for the puck. Gunnarsson gets to it. And Bozak reaching for it. Stepping up, Van Riemsdyk chips it out. And finally, after 90 seconds in the defensive zone, the Maple Leafs will make a change.
And it all started because Colton Orr was late on a line change, and he couldn't get the puck out on the far side. Gordon, it was an easy outlet pass. Again, twice in this period, the Leafs make a good outlet pass, and the forward's not able to get it out of the zone.
Kuhlman to MacArthur. Swings it back, rink wide. Kuhlman, long shot, blocked by Lundqvist, and he'll hang on. Lots of scoring punch in this game. Kadri and Nash going toe-to-toe at MSG.
Disguise the disappointment in Randy Carlyle's face when these two turnovers happen, because the D plays it right to Kessel and he can't get it out. Now Gunnarsson pushes it ahead to Orr. Now Orr isn't expecting that, so he's skating to fly the zone right there. And because of that one, that was a good 90-second shift for the New York Rangers top line, and the Leafs got out of trouble. Okay, they're unscathed, just a bunch of tired legs after that one.
Now Kadri in for the faceoff for Toronto. Nazem Kadri, of 84 eligible players, Darren, is 82nd in faceoff percentage, under 43%. One area of improvement noted by Randy Carlyle that must happen. But Carlyle has used him at times against other teams' top line.
It's a good effort, though, diving back and swatting that puck back in the offensive zone, though, for Kadri.
Now Kuhlman feeds it down and banks across the net, so Kadri's out there against part of the Ranger top line. Right across to Brassard, bouncing puck. O'Byrne picks it up for Toronto. And Ryan O'Byrne banks it off the leg of Nash and ahead to McClemmon. Delzato picks up the bouncing puck and through his legs, Nash poked that ahead to Brassard. Fanuf pokes that back to Gunnarsson. Long lead pass for Komarov, who chips that right down to Lundqvist. And Henrik Lundqvist will hang on. The NHL on TSN is brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads.
Well, there can't be any hesitation here, and he's caught halfway in between Ryan O'Byrne is right there. Tough spot there. When in doubt, maybe get out in that situation. But he's got a long reach, and obviously he showed good defensive and offensive prowess in his debut with the Maple Leafs. Ryan O'Byrne's just a good, strong, big body. A good addition on the right side.
And Riemsdyk along with Kessel and Bozak out there for Toronto. And now brought ahead by Callahan, who skated by the puck. So Tortorella seems comfortable having his top line out against Toronto's number one unit. And Van Riemsdyk in with Kessel. Kessel back in front. Van Riemsdyk shovels that down and tip wide. And along the wall, Gunnarsson keeps it alive for Toronto. Kessel tried to feed that in front. McDonough got in the way. Back to the point it goes to Fanuf. Now Gunnarsson with a shot that's gloved by Lundqvist, and he'll hang on to that. Well, Henrik Lundqvist, Darren, has really had to carry the load as he gets among the lowest goal support in the NHL. The Rangers score just over two goals a game when he starts.
Yeah, he's been outstanding, and you could argue that he's in the race as well for the Vezina Trophy. And certainly Carey Price of Montreal. I would say Antti Niemi in San Jose. And when the Rangers win games, it's largely because of the King in net.
Won the Vezina last year for the first time in his career. Mark Fraser banks that down. And John Moore has it. Looks at the Zuccarello, who just throws it up the center ice, and it's picked up by Cody Franson and John Tortorella look skyward on that turnover. Randy Carlisle and John Tortorella don't really have poker faces back there, do they, Darren?
No, they don't. But, you know, they try to teach the game the correct way to play it. I mean, you turn over the puck in that gray area inside your blue line, you know, you can't accept that. Not this time of year. Those are the little things that you have to do well. And if you're not ready for it at this level, then they want you down in the minors playing. Both coaches are similar in that respect.
Rangers in a play tonight. Time for the final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference with the Winnipeg Jets. They have games in hand on Winnipeg. And a huge game looming this weekend for the Rangers and Islanders, who face each other on Long Island on Saturday. Maple Leafs, meantime, will go home to face Montreal on Saturday. Here's Zuccarello with it. Out there along with Richards and Taylor Pyatt. And Pyatt down low with it. Feeds it across to Richards. Fires! Reimer made the save up high. The puck loose. And James Reimer has it for Toronto. 8:51 to go in the opening period. No score between the Maple Leafs and the Rangers.
Well, the board play is an important part of the game. Kessel comes back here on his backhand, and he tries to flip it, but McDonough just easily bats that out of midair and keeps it in. That's certainly going to be one of the areas that Randy Carlisle will address with the Toronto Maple Leafs in this game. Reimer on the short side just had to get that pad tight, seamed, sealed against the post.
They talk about goal support. James Reimer, the fourth most in the NHL. The Leafs score 3.75 goals a game in his start. So he gets more than a goal a game, more than Lundqvist does for New York.
Yeah, I'm pretty impressed with James Reimer and the way he's handled adversity and all the talk and all the pressure. But being 7-2-2 on the road, stopping 93% of the shots, is pretty darn impressive.
Anton Stroman, long shot tipped, and Reimer makes the save up high on the deflection by Callahan.
Boy, he shrugged those shoulders, didn't he? He does a lot of movement in the warm-up. Like all goaltenders, a lot of pushing, a lot of moving, and obviously going through it, the adjustment of two goalie coaches here. But his athleticism here, he kind of gets square, but he just shrugs those shoulders and keeps it between the mask and the shoulder pad.
Komarov being harassed by Nash, and Delzato can't hold the line for New York. By the way, coming up in our first intermission, a special edition of the quiz featuring an out-of-this-world participant. It's going to be pretty cool. Huh. Yeah.
Well, I know Torch wants no part of it.
No. That would be an out-of-your-mind version of the quiz, not out-of-this-world.
He actually answered a whole bunch of questions before the game today.
He did.
Yep.
And the answers were extensive for him. You asked him a question, and I think the answer was at least 10 seconds long. Kadri across to Fraser, and Fraser bobbled that puck with Taylor Pyatt bearing down on him. Now a bounce to Ryan Hamilton. He turns it over, and Aaron Asham plays it back in for New York. The puck bouncing around at center ice. Scooped up by Steve Ebinger. The defenseman comes in, gets crushed there by Mark Fraser. And Franson brings it ahead for Toronto. Cody Franson, along with Kadri and MacArthur. A long shot, that goes just wide. Kuhlman plays it down to Kadri. And Kuhlman back on it, being tied up there by Asham. Trying to feed that back, and Ebinger has it for New York. Got a long lead pass for Pyatt. Got banged there by O'Byrne. And both teams rattling the glass here in the early going.
Yeah, O'Byrne does a nice job of closing off the center ice line there to force an icing, and it would have been icing as well.
Shots are 5-4 Toronto, and there's 7 to go in the opening period. Oh. Centering pass, Kessel fires, and Lundqvist makes the stop on him.
Good on the forecheck. Bozak makes a nice play behind the net, trying to lure Lundqvist into going to his stick side and then going the other way. Turnover, lifting the stick, backhand pass right on the tape, and you see how low Kessel gets on the ice, getting one knee on the ice, trying to get better leverage on that one. But again, Lundqvist is there. A couple of golden opportunities so far in this game for Kessel.
And the first goal, so important to the New York Rangers. In their last 11 games, the team that has scored first has won every time. The Rangers have allowed the first goal 24 times in 39 games. They've only won 7 times when they haven't scored first. The real problem for them is Tortorella doesn't want to put too much pressure on the score first, but they're so unsuccessful when they don't.
They don't play a game that you can play catch-up. They play a game in which they block a lot of shots in their own zone. They play with a lead. When you're trying to catch up and chase the game like that, you get out of your element. That's what largely happened to the Rangers when they fallen behind.
Brian Boyle hammered there by O'Byrne. There's a couple of big guys colliding in the corner. Lyles on his knees trying to move that away from Hagelin. And it's picked up by Orr. Paul Orr, the former Ranger, got bottled up, trying to backhand it out. Went off Boyle, up and out. And the faceoff will come outside. The NHL on TSN is brought to you by Molson Canadian, brewed with the best this land has to offer.
Well, that clearing attempt, the Rangers try to maybe lure the officials into calling it off, but it definitely glanced out of play. Didn't go clearly out for a delay of game penalty.
Now put up, wraps that around to Van Riemsdyk. Got by everyone. And as McDonough goes back, this will be icing called against Toronto. And there is the captain on his 28th birthday, Dion Phaneuf. Leads his team once again in ice time, averaging over 25 minutes per game.
It's a lot of minutes, but one thing that Ryan O'Byrne's going to help out, Gord, is on the penalty kill. Maybe take a few minutes per game off the shoulders of Dion Phaneuf, give him some fresher minutes on the power play.
Now Kessel reaches for it, McDonough steps in front of him, shoots off Phaneuf's stick. It went right back in front, the bouncing puck got away, it was centered there by Richards, and the Leafs are away three wide. Bozak centers it, McDonough knocks it down and plays it back up to center ice.
Well, these are some grade A turnovers by the Maple Leafs, and the Rangers aren't able to capitalize on these chances.
Now a centering pass for Kessel, shoots, and that dribble just wide. I took a peek down at both benches there, both coaches are shaking their heads. Drop back to Richard, fires into the midsection of James Reimer, and he'll hang on to that. 5:19 to go in the opening period. You're watching Wednesday Night Hockey from New York.
Well, somewhere along the line, you've got to disguise a pass. I mean, this is read quite easily here by McDonough. No chance. Kessel maybe could have cut in there, but that backhand pass is an ill-advised one. And following that, Richards ends up getting the scoring chance. So for Randy Carlyle, he's made these frequent visits over to the guy that runs the forwards. That's former goaltender Scott Gordon. So you know when that path gets worn down, Gord?
Yeah.
Let's get the forwards going here. And let's make sure that these turnovers, they could easily have resulted in a goal against.
Grab the faceoff. Derek Stepan spins and shoots, and Reimer knocks that away. And now Bozak goes ahead to McClubbin. So Bozak came on for the faceoff. He'll make his way off. And McClubbin buys some time and plays it down deep to Komarov. Banks it back to Phaneuf. Gunnarsson feeds back to front. Komarov shoots. Shot down by Lundqvist. And the puck bounced across to McClubbin. And Jay McClubbin goes back to Phaneuf. A little slap pass looking in front. That was knocked away. Stepan centers it. And Callahan was in behind Gunnarsson. But the puck didn't get there.
Oh, good shot there by Komarov, and then he goes right over to Callahan and gives Callahan a little shoulder-to-shoulder right there just inside the blue line.
And John Strawman picks it up for New York. For Carl Hagelin and up for Brian Boyle. All three of those men have spent time in Tortorella's doghouse this year. Hagelin, the most recent resident, as Brassard moves it ahead. Boyle back in three consecutive games in February. And now Boyle trying to find his feet. And Hagelin plays it right back down. Brassard spins and shoots. And Reimer's got that. While TSN's coverage of the Masters continues tomorrow at 2 Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific, with the first round live from Augusta National, TSN's comprehensive coverage presented by RBC. Plus, right after the game, be sure to watch the premiere of 4 Days in April, the Mike Weir story, right here on TSN.
Well, quite often, if you put yourself in a good defensive position, you end up getting offensive chances, and certainly the line led by Jay McClement results in a good chance there by Komarov, trying to go high to the short side, and Lundqvist fights that one off. And you know with Lundqvist, because of how deep he stays in the net, he's got that stay deep, beat the pass kind of theory, and that's the areas that you can beat him is up high like that, but that's a good save.
Centering pass for Richards, bounced away from him. Girardi steps up, and the bounce is back into the corner.
magic!
Darren, I got to think Augusta Nationals on your bucket list, isn't it?
I would say so. Without a doubt.
Lead pass to Kessel, 2-on-1 with Van Riemsdyk. Kessel, trying to feed it back in front now. Kessel back with it behind the goal. Slides it back, shot taken, and Fraser with the shot. It was loose, and a quick whistle from referee Wes McCauley, it appeared, as Van Riemsdyk was battling for space in front.
You know, Wes McCauley was behind the net, and at the point in which it went under the pads of Lundqvist, it looked like he had sealed it off, but it was clearly loose from my vantage point here. Good pass there by Kessel after he can't get the puck over on the original 2-on-1 to Van Riemsdyk, and then there it's under the pad, but it does squeak loose, but from his angle, which is similar to the camera angle right there, it looks like it's covered, but clearly not covered. And to my right is Phil Kessel, and Gord, he's a frustrated camper so far in this game. It's not going his way yet, but if he keeps grinding away at it, he's getting chances, and plays are coming.
Orr plays that down to McLaren, banks away from him, and Emminger has it for New York. You know, played and got the National on his 65th birthday a couple weeks ago, Fanger?
Who's that?
Bobby Orr.
Oh, how good is that? Well, if there's a guy that deserves to go play there on his 61st birthday, it'd be Robert Gordon Orr.
Absolutely, Darren Robert Pettis. 3 to go here in the opening period. Still no scores. Aaron Eichel puts it in for New York. He collides hard with O'Byrne. And Grabowski comes away with it for Toronto. Through the middle to Colton Orr. Banks that down to the Ranger zone.
Not an easy adjustment for Grabowski either.
No.
I mean, being a fourth line centerman, but he's really, I mean, he's got to do what he's got to do. And so far, he's quick shifts, getting it in deep. Can't be easy for him.
A lot of the guys who are into analytics, Darren, you know, the...
Coleman Analytics?
Yeah. We'll tell you that Grabowski is one of Toronto's best players. Randy Carlyle doesn't believe in analytics.
Well... Yeah, because there's a game that has to be played out there, but I think Grabowski at his best is a pretty spunky forward and play with an edge, and but sometimes it's not going your way. You've got to find a way to stay in the lineup. Could easily just be a healthy scratch and sitting in the press box. But
Komarov shoots that in, Lundqvist knocks it away, and Komarov almost got there for his own rebound, and now Frentzen fires it right back in. 10-7, the shots on goal for Toronto. Leafs are number 4 in the NHL in goal scoring. Rangers are number 4 in goals against.
Well, the New York Rangers get some good news here as we take a look at Reimer, but Mark Stahl had a light skate and talked to the media today, and that's awfully good news there for John Tortorella and the New York Rangers. He's obviously a rock-solid defenseman, but that's a wicked injury that he sustained with that puck off the face.
Hopeful that the playoffs are a possibility. The NHL's regular season ends, Darren, in 17 days. MacArthur lays that back. Mark Fraser at the line with it. Slides it back, and MacArthur's centering pass goes off a stick. Up and out of play with 94 seconds to go in the opening period.
Well, in the offensive zone, the Leafs have done a nice job on the faceoffs. And Kadri here going to his backhand there, ties up his man, gets some help from MacArthur, and then Clark MacArthur spins back, trying to get it back to the point for a shot from Fraser. They've won the last 7 faceoffs in the offensive zone.
And this time the draw control by New York. You look at the top faceoff men in the league, Darren, invariably they're older and bigger. The common thread, cool of a long shot, that goes wide. And now Franzen steps up, banks it off the end board. Emminger looks ahead for Brassard, and now Hagelin gets there first for New York. Loose puck on the side of the goal. Reimer makes the save in tight as he stops Brassard. Now Emminger back to Derek Brassard at 4 points in his Ranger debut.
Last minute of play in the period.
Joe Tolleson, the MSG PA announcer, informs us we're in the final 60 seconds of the opening period. And Cody Franson with the Leafs changing. Slides back in behind the Toronto goal. Van Riemsdyk. Being harassed there by Richards. Plays it down to the Rangers zone. And Ryan Clough goes back. That'll be an unforced icing called against Toronto with 31.3 seconds to go. The NHL on TSN is brought to you by Asante from Investment, Tax, and Real Estate Planning to Environment. Asante Wealth Management, get the complete solution.
Well, you have to have support and layers of defensive play in your own zone to be successful. That's a sharp angle shot right there. And then after Reimer makes the save, he gets a little help.
Kessel plays that up. McDonough gathers it back up. Dimension, don't forget, coming up in the first intermission, a special edition of the quiz. Long-distance charges may apply. Derek Stepan swings that across to Nash. In for Stepan. Back in front for Nash. A rolling puck in front. Kessel took a stick in the face. Looks back at the official. There's no call. And in the final seconds of the period, time expires. Phil Kessel arguing he took a high stick. And now Callahan is into it. Van Riemsdyk.
Yeah, Van Riemsdyk gave him a little bit of a half cross-check shove there just from behind at the very end of it. Kessel's frustrated by the high stick, but Gordy, the puck's right near him, and he's got his hands up in the air looking at the referee. And with time winding down, that puck is laying right at his skates, but he was able to flip a little saucer pass up the ice.
No score after the opening 20 minutes. Coming up, our first intermission with James Duthie, the panel, and a guest. Peng, when Phil Kessel scored twice against the Rangers on Monday, those were his first goals in 10 games. It can be frustrating when that's your job.
Well, there's no question about it, especially when you get speed and you're getting through the neutral zone and you're getting quality scoring chances on the road. And you know that the Rangers aren't a team that catch up easily in a hockey game. They end up chasing the game, as we mentioned, so it would get frustrated. And clearly he showed that because the forwards are right to my right and Kessel likes to snuggle up against the glass. But this play here, he's got a two-on-one. Now he was able to make up for it, made a good pass back to the point where they get a good chance. This is in the final seconds. He takes the high stick. He's frustrated with that. Gord, every time he came to the bench, he showed his frustration. He slammed the door. He changed sticks three times during that first period in hopes of finding some magic with one other twig.
So the teams begin this second period 5-on-5. There's not yet been a power play in the hockey game.
Well, I know the coaches were talking a lot about to the linesmen before we dropped the puck here, just about the drop into the puck and maybe the visiting team getting a little cheating going on, and the Leafs were great in the offensive zone in that first period.
Toronto won 68% of the faceoffs in the opening 20 minutes.
Especially good in the offensive zone, huh, Gord?
And Grabowski was 4-0. Michael Delzato spinning back for New York. And he's logging elevated minutes now with Mark Stahl in the lineup. He's been over 25 minutes a game routinely. Steve Eminger slides that down. Brassard played it down behind the Leafs goal. And it's scooped up by Carl Gunnarsson to the line, but Eminger once again kept that alive. And Zuccarello is trailing Gunnarsson now. Pinnock tries to poke that ahead. Kuhlman can't clear it out. John Moore with a shot. That was blocked.
It's a good block there by Hamilton. You can see why Randy Carlyle has a lot of faith in Hamilton. He's a leader in the American Hockey League, where they're only 2 points out of their conference lead right there. But that's a good shot block, dragging the leg.
And Morgan Riley, whose junior season just ended, having an impressive pro debut as a member of that Marley team. Bouncing puck down to MacArthur. Loose it, but poked down. And Lundqvist makes an unbelievable save on Kadri.
Oh, that puck was just on edge as Kadri got to it. And Lundqvist again bails out the New York Rangers. Two good scoring chances by the Leafs as they enter the offensive zone. So good heads-up pass there by Cody Franzen. And with a slick little bouncing pass right there, protecting the puck is MacArthur. The first save, and then the second one, you see his Lundqvist lunges to his left, and then he has to reverse it and push back to his right, and that stops the Kadri little play right there.
While he's losing his goal stick.
All that in a bag of chips.
Bozak hacked that drawback, and it's fired wide by Kessel. Gunnarsson. Down low to Van Riemsdyk. And Phaneuf back with it. Van Riemsdyk also ended a long drought with the goal against the Rangers on Monday. Phaneuf winds his way in, feeds in front. Callahan has knocked away. They score! And it's Kessel who pokes it home. The Maple Leafs have the lead 1-0.
Looks like he found the magic twig. And Kessel's hunting the puck in front of the net. Phaneuf ends up keeping that puck in. Right here, he draws it back to his forehand, keeps it in. Nice little pass there by Kessel, right back to Phaneuf. And then this one looks like it was broken down. Callahan has it. I mean, Callahan's got it on his backhand here. So right here, oh, got it on the backhand, but Kessel follows through with it. And that's what would disturb the goaltender. He's thinking that it's on the tape of his own player. And before he knows it, it's by the glove side with a quick stick of Kessel.
And Kessel's got three goals in this home-and-home series against the New York Rangers. So a good week for the Kessel family. They've scored Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And there's a puck into the Ranger bench. Of course, Amanda, Phil's sister, scored the winner for Team USA last night in the gold medal game of the World Women's Hockey Championship against Canada in Ottawa.
Well, I understand how frustrating it can be when you're getting chances and you show that frustration. But as long as you're hunting it in the area, I think the most frustrating part is when you're not getting chances. And as a goaltender, I would take about 15 shots from a fourth line rather than a couple of shots from a top winger in the league. They always manage to find the net.
And in behind the play, Ryan Klo is going to tangle with Mark Fraser. So the Maple Leafs with their league-leading 40th fight of the year. Last year was the Rangers who led the league in fighting penalties, and this is nasty.
Couple of left jabs. Fraser's got the reach.
And Fraser's sweater has come partially off. So Fraser and Klo will get themselves back together and serve their 5 minutes. And we mentioned that it's been a pretty good week for the Kessel family. Phil scores two on Monday against the Rangers. Amanda scores the winner last night with a great shelf job for Team USA. And then Phil tonight.
Yeah, both right-hand shots. He could have borrowed his sister's stick right there. They both tape it the same way on the shaft to get better grip there like that, and
both
she likes going high glove. He likes going high glove. A lot of similarities there.
Both played at the University of Minnesota. And Kessel with a little smile now for the Toronto. Amazing how that goes, huh?
Yep.
You can't buy one, and you get kind of a funny bounce in front, swatted off a guy's stick, and all of a sudden, you're a red-hot goal scorer.
The go-ahead goal in the game on Monday. He fanned on the first one. It goes into the pads, and he's able to capitalize on the rebound.
Now Bozak with a steal, and Tortorella's doing another slow burn on the Ranger bench. So the Rangers once again allow the first goal in a game. That's the 25th time in 40 games they've been scored on first. And it's been nearly a month since the Rangers won a game when they didn't score the first goal. Richards winds his way in, turns that puck over, and Kuhlman chips it ahead to Kadri. Azem Kadri. Back to Carl Gunnarsson, shoots short side, bouncy puck loose in front, Kuhlman trying to find it, and it squirts wide, a penalty coming up to New York. Now Lyles with it. Kuhlman banks it in front, MacArthur leaves it there, the extra skate is on for Toronto. As Lyles plays it back to Francis. Clark MacArthur sends it rink wide to Kuhlman. Kicks that back to Lyles. To Francis. MacArthur snaps it across. Kuhlman with time. Snaps it on goal. Saved made by Lundqvist. And he takes the rebound away from Nazem Kadri. But a chipping penalty coming to New York as Delzato goes off and the Maple Leafs go to the power play.
Power play's 13th ranked in the NHL at 18.4%, but on the road it's impressive as you see that trip up right there and Kuhlman right in front of the goaltender, Henrik Lundqvist, and with good puck possession and James Reimer on the bench for an extra attacker, Kuhlman does a nice job on the far boards, keeping that in and then reversing it back to John Michael Lyles on the left point. So good puck possession time, but an easy save on the sharp angle there by Lundqvist. Power play on the road, Gord, is impressive at 20.9% for the Maple Leafs.
Van Riemsdyk, Bozak, and Kessel up front. Frantzen and Phaneuf on the back end. Dion Phaneuf has 104 career goals there in the NHL, 60 of them on the power play. And Kessel fires that down as McDonough waits for it. Bozak picks it up in the corner. Crucial game for the Rangers, battling for a playoff spot after going to the Eastern Conference Final a year ago. Phaneuf snaps it across to Kessel. And Kessel being double-teamed, banks it off the leg of Stefan. And Van Riemsdyk pitches for it down low. Out of the stick of Callahan, and he'll fire it down.
A lot of times when the defenseman brings it to the middle of the ice, obviously there's two options. Shoot it at the net or fire it off to the half boards. But that one by Dion Phaneuf was a little too firm. A slap shot over to Kessel. Hard to handle that one.
Mentioned the Rangers had the best record in the Eastern Conference last year, Darren, but what a turnover, really. In less than a year since going to the sixth game of the Eastern Conference Final, nearly a third of their team is different. Gunnarsson to MacArthur. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Gunnarsson kept that alive. Here's Lyles with it. Back to Gunnarsson. He's across to MacArthur. A rolling puck shoots off the outside of the goal. And Kessel on it. Back to Lyles. He finds MacArthur to Gunnarsson. Back to MacArthur. Feeds it across to Kessel. Looking for MacArthur. Intercepted by Boyle. And he'll pound that down into the Toronto zone.
John Michael Lyles wanted that puck at the left point. And I think that was the first instinct and option for Kessel. But then he just hesitated for a second and gave it away going through the middle.
There goes the door again as Kessel gives it a hard slam. And the final seconds now, the Toronto power play. MacArthur to Grabowski. That was blocked by Callahan. And Delzano's back up for New York. Picks up a loose puck. He's got Stefan and Callahan with him. Derek Stefan lines and fires, partially blocked as Gunnarsson got in the way. And that seemed to shake up Carl Gunnarsson.
Oh, yeah.
He was limping back slowly to the Toronto bench. McDonough with it now. Looks ahead to Nash. And Nash's pass turned away as it's fed back down to the Ranger line. 16-8 with the shots on goal in favor of Toronto. The Maple Leafs with a 1-0 lead. And the goal by Kessel, his 13th of the year. Ryan Hamilton has that knocked away by Emminger. And Steve Emminger plays that quickly ahead. Hagler looks rink wide for Zuccarello. Matt Zuccarello, the native of Norway. Banks that down to the Toronto zone. Here's Brassard looking for it. Brassard got tied up by McClement. And Zuccarello plays that back to McDonough. Across to Girardi. That centering pass knocked down by McClement. Now Zuccarello back on it. The pass too far for Brassard. Girardi took part in the Hamilton. And the puck squirts back down to the Rangers zone.
Oh, good quick up right there by the Rangers.
John Moore to Zuccarello centers it. Great chance in front. And the Ranger player taken down. A penalty coming to Toronto as Brassard was sent hard into the end board. And the New York Rangers will go to the power play when we come back to Madison Square Garden on Wednesday Night Hockey on TSN. The complete solution. Well, Ryan Klo from St. John's, Newfoundland got traded a lot closer to home. That's great news for his dad because the time difference from St. John's to San Jose is 5.5 hours.
Now, I know.
Now Mr. Klo can get to bed early after his son's games instead of getting up early to watch it.
I know he's only got 2 goals, but he brings a lot to the table, and that fight was certainly one of the aspects of his game.
That pass skipped away from Nash. And now McClement moves it out for Toronto. The play was called offside at the Toronto line.
Well, I've seen a lot of Klo playing in San Jose and certainly a lot of big games. He's a tough, gritty winger. And you know in this situation, he'll get himself in front of the net when he does end up getting on the ice.
Unrestricted free agent this summer. Puck fired down to the Rangers zone. Maple Leafs have killed off 33 of the last 35 opposition penalties they have faced. And enter this game tied for third in penalty killing after being bottom five for each of the last 6 years. Well, don't forget the NHL on TSN. On now with the Bruins and the Devils on TSN 2. New Jersey sinking like a rock in the Eastern Conference standings. Got to get back on the beam. The Devils have two left against the Rangers. Now right now, Boston with the big lead in that one. So New Jersey running out of answers and running out of time.
Certainly need Kovalchuk back in the lineup.
No kidding, huh?
Man.
Callahan had that bounce away, and Jay McClement picks it up.
Jay McClement really gained some notoriety playing for Andy Murray in the St. Louis Blues, part of the gray line, the checking line.
Great move by Nash. Drops it back, scooped up by Broussard. Ranger power play. Not getting much zone time so far. Now gets set up as Nash slides that back to Richard. Brad Richard feeds across. Delzalo shoots us off the outside of the goal. And O'Byrne gets it to it and fires that down the ice. And there's what you talked about earlier, Darren. Ryan O'Byrne relieves Phaneuf of some penalty killing time.
Yep, that means a lot for Phaneuf. And that's a good shot block by O'Byrne. He got a lot on that. And the goaltender can read that play because of where O'Byrne was.
Now Richard the left point. Oh. Down to Broussard. Back to Richard. Works in, shoots, and Reimer saw it all the way. Chips it up, but out of play. And now Brian Boyle jawing with Dion Phaneuf.
Yeah, because Boyle gave him sort of an offensive, you know, cross-check. You know, usually it's the D that do that, but Boyle did it. There's a shot block by O'Byrne. The big right-hander gets down there, takes it on the knee. This is in front. So you see with Klo there, just before that, Boyle gives Dion Phaneuf a shove from behind, and it jarred the helmet of Dion Phaneuf, so the visor was on the bridge of his nose, and that's why he went over to Boyle, the big centerman.
Big face off now. Tail end of the power play. Bozak wins it, but the Maple Leafs can't clear as O'Byrne couldn't get it out. McDonough feeds it down. Girard able for that pass of Broussard. A long shot. Reimer reaches back to make that save. And the penalized player, Colt Moore, is back on the ice. Boyle picks up the bouncing puck. These penalty killers have been out there for a while. Broussard on it now. Banks that back to McDonough. A long shot. That goes wide. Off the end boards. Close slides it back. Girardi a long shot. Hit Broussard in the back of the leg. And Bozak has that for Toronto. Slides it down, and the Maple Leafs can start their change. Shots now 16-9 in favor of Toronto. The Rangers had just one shot on goal on that power play. And the Maple Leafs have now killed off 34 of the last 36. That was the one area there that they struggled with. Goals against and penalty killing for the last six seasons.
Always been great on the defensive side of the puck, so no surprise that they made the improvements.
Lyle, diagonal pass for MacArthur. Bounced away from him, back to Cody Francis, back to Lyle. John Michelotto shoots hard off the end boards, and Delzotto picks it up. But halfway through this game, in a crucial part of the season there, the Rangers have nine shots on goal on home ice. Hagelin races to it. He's taken down by Franson, and now MacArthur spins back. Stephon watching him. Bouncing puck goes to Anton Strahlman. His shot deflects wide. Now Hagelin back with it. Hagelin sends it back in front. Reimer got a piece of that. Stephon drops it back. He's got a shot. Reimer, Hagelin scores! With his first goal in nearly a month, ties it up and won.
Well, very little pressure in this period by the Rangers, but this one here looks like MacArthur originally wanted to go to his backhand. He switches to his forehand, and Strahlman had already pitched in towards the hash mark. From now, it's a lacrosse ball hanging around the net, bobbling and Bobblin, and finally it goes to Hagel on a very sharp angle, and he's able to rip it back. Reimer's trying to get back with a push with his right edge to get back to the left, but can't get there enough and gets no help in front.
So Hagelin, who played fewer than 11 minutes on Monday night in Toronto, gets a huge tying goal for New York on the range of the 11th shot on goal. And re-energizes this MSG crowd.
That's why this shift is so important on both sides. It's got to be a bounce back shift for the Leafs, and the Rangers want to put their foot back on the throat again.
Now Dennis throws it wide, and Reimer sprawls and off the rebound away. Well, in two key situations on Monday, Darren, the Rangers gave away momentum. After Nash scored to cut the lead to 2-1, they took a bad holding penalty. Ryan Callahan, Toronto scored the power play. And then 39 seconds after they tied it at 3, Kessel got the go-ahead goal to cement the 4-3 win. Here it's 1-1 with 8:23 to go in the second period.
Is so important, and at this point here, MacArthur thinks that John Michael Lyles would take his place on the left wing, and MacArthur actually looks at him like, you just got to stay there because you're the outlet. I'm playing it along the boards, and then Kuhlman tries to half-heartedly block the shot. It goes off his left elbow and right over to Hagelin, and even on the sharp angle with a bouncing puck, Hagelin's able to bang it in there.
And the game's two goal scorers sharing a laugh. By the way, I want to correct something. I misspoke a moment ago, Darren. 4.5 hours from St. John's to San Jose, not 5.5.
Oh, that's okay, Gord.
Well, you know, but the good news is only 3 Newfoundlanders at TSN emailed me.
Klo had an opportunity, too, before the Rangers just tied the game. He had a golden opportunity, and the puck bounced away from him, kind of the way the luck's been going around the net for Ryan Klo this year with just 2 goals.
But Callahan shoots, and Reimer makes the save. What a quick chance for Callahan. Closed captioning is brought to you by Steel. Built to last, priced to sell.
Well, Callahan certainly picks up a lot of speed here. MacArthur's back, the defenseman in the gap closures, not real solid as a 5-man unit through the neutral zone there for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
And the shots on goal gap is narrowing. Now 16-12 in favor of Toronto as the puck bounces in front. Bozak trying to find it. And it gets away from Hagelin. Here's Van Riemsdyk. His pass too far for Kessel. And McDonough banks it out.
I say this, Gord, the communication here on the bench of the Maple Leafs is really, really solid. A lot of heads up, pucks in your feet, good constant communication from the bench.
Callahan trying to center it, that's knocked down by O'Byrne. And Brassard banks it back for Girardi. Fires it in front, looking for the stick of Hagelin, that went wide. And Brassard back on it. Another first round pick of the Columbus Blue Jackets.
Yeah, the areas that he has struggled in his young career being a centerman and has to be a top six centerman in the NHL is at 5-on-5 and on the defensive side of it. I talked to his former coach in Columbus, Ken Hitchcock, now of the St. Louis Blues, and that was one of the issues certainly with Brassard. But with the puck, Gord, he's a pretty nifty player.
Sixth overall pick of the 2006 draft out of Drummondville in the Quebec Major Junior League. Meantime, the Rangers and Maple Leafs locked at 1, 7:09 to go in the second period. Komarov took that faceoff, lost it to Stepan. And now Pinot trails back for Toronto. And the Rangers will start the change now as Nash comes on. And the puck bounces to Ryan Hamilton. On in. It's tangled up in the corner. Eminger falls. Now Hamilton back on it. Komarov for Toronto. Tied up there by John Moore. Now McClemens back on it. And the battle continues down low. as Komarov from coming. And Hamilton going to work, and now it's finally moved out. Zuccarello swings it rink wide. And long shot by Moore off the outside of the net. And now John Moore, the defenseman in deep. Now a New York Ranger, a former Kitchener Ranger. And the puck hacked out and down the ice by McClement. And icing waved off as it died near the goal line.
Well, when teams are on a roll too, they get that weak side defenseman jump into the play as the major form of an outlet. That's going to be icing right there. Oh, the fans thought that Boyle got to that with that long reach. And 6'7" frame of Boyle, he doesn't, I didn't believe from my vantage point, got to it. No, he did not. Great call by the linesman right there. Wonderful call. I don't know how they see that. That was very close. Good effort on both sides.
That was Greg Dvorsky with the call. And the draw won by Bozak, so these Rangers are going to have to stay on the ice a bit. As Kessel gets to it, hard pass for Bozak, trying to chip that back to Lyles. And it was moved out by Richards. And O'Byrne sends that down to the New York zone. Lundquist feeds that across to Anton Strahlman. Banks it back up to center ice. One of the all-time great Tortorella quotes about Anton Strahlman. When we got him, I didn't like him. I didn't know him. And when I first saw him, I didn't like him.
Well, before the game, he talked about how tough he's been playing. Not physical fighting tough, but just hard tough. Taking hits to make plays and doing the little things well.
That centering pass just missed the stick of Kessel. And Grabowski out there with Van Riemsdyk and Kessel. Van Riemsdyk plays it back to Franson. To Mark Fraser. Tries to bank it off the end boards. It goes across to Van Riemsdyk. And now Franson had the puck squirt over his stick and out. And Brian Boyle stepped hard into Van Riemsdyk and they tangle right in front of the roof hanger.
Yeah, that's a big body there in Boyle. That stick came close, but I'm so short it went over my head.
Well, they're all kind of big D, aren't they, Panger?
Well, kind of.
But you've got gumption, young man. In comes Colton Orr. Spins off a check of backhand shot, goes wide. And Gunnarsson steps up for Toronto. Now Moore spins back. Moore, a first-round pick of the Blue Jackets in 2009. Eminger backhands that wide to the goal. Taylor Pyatt looking for it. And Aaron Asham steps up for the Rangers as the puck comes free in the corner. Lyles looks across to Gunnarsson. Brassard comes out. And Komarov finds Lyles. Under four to go now in the second period. John Michael Lyles has it knocked away. And Brassard goes ahead to Hagler. Carl Hagler, the Ranger goal scorer tonight. One of the flat-out top skaters in the NHL. McClement tried to bank that up. The puck loose in the Toronto zone. Now scooped up and moved ahead by Lyle. And Lyle sweeps that down to the Ranger line. Callahan picks it up. And New York quickly counterattack. Hagler works it and shoots off the glove of Reimer. It dribbles wide. There. McDonough spins around. Country shoots. Ryan McDonough fires it through traffic. And the Rangers have the lead.
Break for the Leafs. John Michael Lyles, he tries to get the red line and get it in deep. It goes off of the linesman in the neutral zone, and from that point on the play goes the other way. Lyles is out of gas. He's just trying to get it in deep, and the bench was yelling get it deep at that point, but it's a bad break going off the linesman, and the shot on goal misses. But watch how easily this shot is floated through. McDonough does a nice job of changing the angle. It's just a wrist shot. But because of the traffic by Callahan in front of the net, Reimer's looking for it, drops his mitt, and it goes high over the glove side.
McDonough will get his fourth of the year. And as we mentioned, his minutes have been greatly elevated since Mark Stahl went out, and he's got a huge goal for New York, a 2-1 Ranger lead here in the second period.
Well, the Rangers have climbed back into this game. Kadri's got to do a better job of getting in front of that shooting lane. And with traffic there, Reimer goes down. Reimer reason. Look at the breakdown. Glove side high. 16 this year, low 6. So with all the video and all the technology, you can go through 110 goals against of any goaltender. You can pinpoint any area that you think you can capitalize on. And certainly teams are thinking they can go high glove. But in all fairness to James Reimer, you can't see that puck whatsoever. It's a perfectly placed shot. Little wrister, not much on it by McDonough.
Now Stroman lost the puck to Komarov, and in comes Hamilton with it. Ryan Hamilton feeds it across to Phaneuf. Lots of traffic in front of Phaneuf. Sends a long wrist shot wide of the goal. And Zuccarello taps that back for Nash. Rick Nash feeds it across. Long shot by Stepan in the leg, and Phaneuf banks it high off the glass and down the ice. And this will be an icing call against Toronto. Another 2.5 to go in the second period.
Well, the thing about Rick Nash, if you're the Toronto Maple Leafs, he protects the puck so well. He can gain speed through the neutral zone, so you got to have good gap closure on him. I thought this was offside, and clearly it was offside there. But because of that, it gets into the offensive zone, and then the Maple Leafs end up icing the puck. Tortorella decides to make a change, takes Nash off the ice.
So now Brassard with Haglund and Callahan. One thing is, if you keep track of Ranger lines, you should do it in pencil. Because John Tortorella is bound to make changes. And it's hard to find a New York player who hasn't felt his wrath this year. Girardi would be one exception.
Expectations high. I mean, how many analysts out there, pundits, didn't think that the Rangers were going to be on top of the East or right there? So it's been a struggle. But a lot of times you go through this adversity, it can help you go through the tough times. You build a little bit going into the playoffs.
There's an offside called at the Toronto line with 1:57 to go in the second period. Tonight's TSN Netcam is brought to you by LASIK MD, providing you with a 2020 view of all the action. Jord Miller, Darren Pang, Mark Masters here at Madison Square Garden on this Wednesday night. Devils are trailing the Bruins 3-0, so a huge opportunity tonight for New York to gain some ground on New Jersey. To mention the Rangers enter play tonight, tied with Winnipeg for the final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference, using up a game in hand tonight. Now McDonough comes back in. Reimer was saved. The rebound bounced away from Zuccarello in front. And Bozak sends that high in the air by McDonough and up to center ice.
The New York Rangers D are becoming more and more active. We saw that with Moore. We saw that with McDonough right there. And McDonough just funnels the puck towards the goaltender, trying to get a rebound chance.
Here it comes again. Sends it across to Nash. Shoot! And the fluttering puck knocked down by Gunnarsson in front. Nash races to the rebound. Feeds it across to Zuccarello. And back for Girardi. Here's Nash with it in the corner. Fights off a check. Works it back in front. Drops it back. Calzano with a drive. And James Reimer makes the save. And now Phaneuf takes a swat in the face from Zuccarello. Happy birthday, Dion Phaneuf.
Well, the Rangers' puck movement is much improved here as this game goes on, and the Maple Leafs are going to have to do a better job of exiting their zone. There's the play again. Nash just buys so much time, plays it to Delzato with the shot in front. There's the push there with the left hand, but then Zuccarello comes up.
Darren, I saw Mark Messier on Monday in Ottawa. He said the last 2 weeks, Rick Nash has been an absolute beast for New York.
Yeah, no question. I mean, talk at the beginning of Derek Stepan, you know, as consistent as Derek has been, and he's really coming into his own, it's hard to say that Nash hasn't been their best player.
Long shot knocked down in front, and then the rebound goes to Boyle. Reimer shuts him down and hangs on to the shot clock now. favors the Rangers 18-16.
Yeah, they're starting to feel a little momentum. You can see that on the bench. There's a lot more talking. There's a lot more energy now coming from the bench of the New York Rangers. And not surprisingly, the Maple Leafs have run out a little bit of gas here late in the second.
Scramble draw goes into the corner to Clough. And Delzato banks that off the leg, kept alive by Boyle. He looks down for Clough, tied up by Francis. And Nikolaj Kuhlman goes ahead to Bozak, to McClement. Richards fell at the line. Bozak comes streaking in. And the play is called as the puck went off that rounded stanchion at the Toronto bench.
Yes, it did. Jay McClement goes to the backhand, and it just goes off the corner. And that's the reason. But you can see Ben Scrivens, he's got the chalk line right there. No, it wasn't off the corner. It was off the steel stanchion there. And we'll see where exactly it does go off.
Yeah, and you know what?
It does go off the steel part of it, but tough call for the referee actually made the call, who was in the defensive zone, who was in the New York Rangers zone at the time. I think it was Wes McCauley that actually made the call.
In that, Ryan Clough, never shy to express himself as having words with Komarov, the linesman, and referee Wes McCauley.
Feisty combination, though, on Komarov. A Finn.
Sort of.
And a Russian.
he's Estonian.
Yeah. Yeah.
Moved to Finland to a Swedish-speaking town. Close long shot, ramps off a stick, up and out of play with 18.3 seconds to go. But Komarov's been a nice addition for Toronto this year. Played for Dynamo Moscow last year in the KHL. Not a big guy, 26 years old in his rookie year, but he's helped out.
Yeah, rock solid. I know when Dave Poulin had seen him play in the KHL and they watch him. I mean, obviously he's got some grit to his game. He's got some sandpaper to his game.
Maple Leafs have not had a shot on goal in the last 16 minutes of this game. In the final seconds of the second, Girardi picks it up. Back of the line, Gunnarsson tries to knock it down. The long shot flutters wide. And the New York Rangers, with a late pair in the second period, have seized a 2-1 lead after 40 minutes. We'll send you now to James Dethney, our second admission with the panel. Rangers got Ryan Clough for a couple of reasons. Net front presence, some physical play in the corner, and also what he does with his gloves off.
No question about it. And the timing of when to throw them down and when to fight. I mean, he is having some tough luck around the net, although he scored two as a member of the Rangers. But while trailing 1-0, Madison Square Garden was absolutely quiet. Nothing happening with the Rangers. Whether this meant the change in momentum or not, you can't be entirely sure, but it was a heck of an effort in that fight against Frazier. And then you end up getting the one goal by Hagelin, his ninth, to make it 1-1. And then a bad break and a line change for the Toronto Maple Leafs as Lyles is dumping it. It goes off the linesman. And then Kadri comes out to his point man. McDonough doesn't stop, kind of swoops away. And McDonough just fires that little eye seam shot high to the glove side.
New York Rangers this season are 11-0 when leading after two. So they didn't get the first goal tonight, but they got the next two after a crazy first period, Darren. The Maple Leafs had the first five shots on goal, the second, and the Rangers had the last 10.
A disappointment in that second period is a chance to go 2-0, or at least create better scoring chances. After Kessel made it 1-0, the Leafs did have a power play, their only power play of the game, 3.5 minutes into the second period, but got nothing going there.
Now Phil Kessel and Derek Brassard are giving each other a whack.
Yeah. Brassard has been in the middle of a few little minor scuffles in this hockey game, trying to get in the kitchen and rattle some pans around there. Stick right between the legs of Phil Kessel.
Now meantime, Mikhail Grabowski is out with Komarov and McClement. So Grabowski began the game playing on the fourth line, gets a bump up. We'll keep an eye on Nazem Kadri, who's minus two for Toronto and has not had a shift since the goal, and now jumps over the boards now for Toronto.
Grabowski played on that line in the game Monday, but now down by one. Look for a little more offense.
score! Komarov leaves it there for Richard. And now Brian Boyle. Interesting that Jake Gardner is a healthy scratch again tonight for Toronto. Made some comments that he's confused and not sure why he's not playing. And Randy Carlyle makes it clear everyone will earn their ice time, but young players have to earn it even more. And what's interesting is with the Stanley Cup playoffs approaching, the Maple Leafs have so few players with experience. Brian Boyle comes busting in, shuttles that on goal, and Reiner shuts him down at short side. Penalty coming up to Toronto. Centering pass bounced off the stick of Zuccarello, who looks skyward. But the Rangers will get an early power play here in the third period as the holding call goes against Carl Gunnarsson.
That's just the size of Boyle protecting the puck and driving hard to the post on the glove side of goaltender James Reimer. And Gunnarsson actually just reaches out. I thought Gunnarsson did a really good job at the beginning, but then he reaches out with his left hand and clearly grabs the elbow and the arm of Boyle after the play. I think if he stays with it and keeps that stick on the hand on the stick for a split second more, the play's behind the net and there's no attempt, no danger there.
So the Maple Leaf penalty killing, which has been exceptional in the last 3 weeks or so, goes back to work, coming up 34 of the last 36 opposition power play. And Delzato will set things up. Derek Stepan winds his way in, drops that across. Callahan rings it around. Zuccarello looking for it. Right now, Delzato, the only man back for New York. And now Nash drifts back to the line. Four forwards on the ice for the Rangers on the power play. Here's Callahan at the point, back for Delzato. Michael Delzato to Matt Zuccarello. Delzato to Nash. Beats the step on, taps it back to Delzato. He and Nash about 2 feet apart. Nash now winds his way in. Drops it down, that pass broken up by Fraser. And McClement plays it down.
Good read there by Fraser.
Lead pass comes in for Callahan. And turned around, Komarov picks up the loose puck and plays it out. Derek Brassard chips that down in the corner, and Cody Franson gets to it, fires it by Strahlman and down the ice. Seconds to go in this New York Ranger power play as Brassard steps around Komarov. Van Riemsdyk took a whack at him as well. Now O'Byrne goes off the glass and chipped that by Strahlman. Now Komarov racing to it. He and Girardi collide in the corner. And Komarov kind of left that puck at Girardi so he could hit him.
It was a good play. He was going to separate Girardi from the puck, and he did so.
Now McDonough comes walking in. His pass broken up by Kadri. And McDonough with it now. The teams are back to even strength.
A great stick there by Kadri. Great stick right there nullifying that play. And good penalty killing. The second part of that penalty kill for the Leafs was terrific. While it was one and done for the Rangers and no shots on goal.
18-16, the shots on goal in favor of New York. At one point, it was 16-8 Toronto. McDonough with it. And Ryan Clough able to chip that out. Ryan O'Byrne across to John Michael Lyles. Lyles has earned the trust of the coach. Remember back in February, he was a healthy scratch in 12 consecutive games.
That helps that he and Ryan O'Byrne know each other and played together a little bit in Colorado. But I think John Michael Lyles' assets are with the puck. He makes great outlet passes. And a good skater getting out of trouble.
Boyle long shot. Reimer will save it out of midair. Aaron Asham almost batted that one in.
Good hand-eye coordination there by Asham.
Might have earned him a contract with the Yankees.
Yeah. And Reimer does a good job of just standing firm on the short side. Boyle picks up a little speed here and then just fires it at the net. The juicy rebound comes out. But yeah, terrific hand-eye coordination. Lunging to the left after the save was made there. Smothering the short side, getting his body firm against the post. And look at that reaction by Aaron Asham.
Stepan wins that drawback. The Maple Leafs still with a wide edge in faceoffs in this game, and now the lead pass goes to Kuhlman. Nikolai Kuhlman trying to fend that pass in front for Grabowski. He spun his man around. No penalty on the play. And now Strowman goes down. Nash with a streaking Zuccarello. A hard pass goes off his stick into the corner. Zuccarello gets hammered there with a high stick from Dion Phaneuf. And the penalty being called by referee Ghislain Bear. Now is Zuccarello cut.
Remember at the end of the second period in front of the Leafs net,
yes.
Phaneuf and Zuccarello.
Two or four.
Number three, minor penalty, by sticking.
And it's two.
Well, Zuccarello actually wears his visor. You talk about wearing a visor to protect yourself. His visor is up fairly high. It's slung upwards there, barely covers his eyebrows. But all this is just a smaller player and a bigger player going over top of him right there. Especially when Zuccarello ends up in that crouch like that. He's as short as I am.
Easy there, Slugger. Posak wins the draw. The Maple Leafs pound it down the ice. And the Rangers back to work on the man advantage. Derek Stepan fires that down. Zuccarello took another hard buck this time from Alberta. And the puck comes free to Callahan. Spins and shoots at it. Fraser. And it's banked down the ice. Mark Fraser and his family know a lot about defense. He plays in the NHL and his brother works in the Department of National Defense in Ottawa. Callahan feeds it back to Delzato. Now Stepan. Long shot hit Franzen in front. And the loose puck poked back to Delzato. Michael Delzato whips it across to Stepan. In for Nash. Zuccarello standing in front. Stepan. To Delzato, crowd hollering for a shot. Hard pass, bounce off the stick of Stepan. And Nash's pass knocked away by Komarov.
Great job by the Leafs getting to the shooting lane, but boy, oh boy, the Rangers had a couple of chances to fire that puck right in the middle of the ice. They're reluctant to fire it.
Callahan steps away from McClement. And McClement reached back and knocked that away. Jay McClement plays low penalty kill minutes and any forward in the league. In comes Kuhlman, taken down by Brassard. 30 seconds to go on the Ranger power play. 13 and a half to go in the period. 2-1 New York leading. Fraber hammers Ryan Clough. Those two met earlier with their gloves off. And now the puck bounces into the Ranger bench with 18 seconds to go in the Phaneuf penalty.
Well, you're right about McClement averaging 3 minutes and 32 seconds, tied with Scuderi for the most while shorthanded. This one here should have been a call, a tripping call on Kuhlman. It does a really nice job of driving wide, but for Jay McClement, this is a guy that just knows the game, understands the game, a real pro, does a lot of video work, a lot of detail-oriented work. The Kingston, Ontario native is a pro's pro, and he is a great signing by the Maple Leafs.
One of the first free agents to sign on July 1st. And maybe not one of the most heralded signings, but he's been tremendous for Toronto. Went over to Colorado as part of that Eric Johnson deal with St. Louis. It sent Chris Stewart and Kevin Shattenkirk to the Blues. Brassard gets around Bozak and feeds that down to the Toronto zone. The teams are back to 5-on-5. And Tyler Bozak looks ahead to Kessel. Girardi intercepted the back pass. Kessel knocked it back down, but Van Riemsdyk was offside. Lyles being trailed there by Boyle.
Good gap closure there by John Michael Lyles. Taking away the blue line, giving Boyle no speed whatsoever.
Now Lyles turns that over, and Ashton fires it back down to the Toronto zone.
I think the forwards of Toronto, though, Gord, can do themselves a favor and be a better outlet for the defenseman of the Leafs. Start in your own zone, play on the defensive side of it, then go up the ice and get a chance.
Haglund slides that ahead to Ashton. And now Girardi with a misplay, and Van Riemsdyk's away with Kessel. James Van Riemsdyk, Ian Kessel shoots. Oh, what a stop! Now he scores! Kessel poked it in. Lundqvist got a piece, but not all of it. And Kessel's got two. The game is tied.
Well, I thought that was under the left pad of Lundqvist. I thought he made a brilliant save. But this is a turnover at the right point. Girardi, Asham made a little saucer pass towards him, and Girardi can't keep it in. And Van Riems, like, uses some speed, protects the puck, makes the pass across, and, well, clearly right in the middle of the net, but the puck doesn't pop out, and that's why there was a little delay in the celebration. But it clearly beats him just inside the skate and the near post. Perfect execution. Great pass by Van Riemsdyk, too, to protect the puck and lay that little saucer pass right over there to Kessel, the goal-scoring winger.
First Maple Leaf shot in more than 24 minutes of play, and the game is tied at 2. And Phil Kessel has 4 goals in this home-and-home series between the Rangers and the Maple Leafs. And now it dribbles down to Reimer, and he'll hang on. 2-2 the score in the third period. Wednesday Night Hockey returns to New York after this.
Well, Aaron Asham does the right thing in trying to get it back to the defenseman Girardi, but he puts it in his skate, so it pops off his skate over the stick, and Van Riemsdyk is the recipient of that, but Van Riemsdyk does, I guess, a great job of just moving forward. And now Kessel doesn't know it's in the net. Look, they're all looking around. Bozak's looking. He's like, hey, I scored a goal!
How about that?
There was the delay because the puck ends up bouncing up and on the camera in the net.
Amazing. You know, Kessel with 4 straight 30-goal years, but really does score in bunches. Remember how he started the year, no goals in his first 10. Now Stroman taken down by Kuhlman, and the Rangers agitated about that. So a 2-2 game here in the third period. By the way, the last 2 days, Darren, Sunday and Monday, the first 2 in the NHL season consecutively in which there were no overtime games. Kuhlman works in, shoots, Lundqvist makes a save on him. And Zuccarello had that knocked down by Gunnarsson.
Now the change in momentum, change in energy on the bench. The Leafs come out after that game-time goal, and they get some pop to their step right there, getting in the offensive zone. That's a great chance on Lundqvist. Lundqvist not only plays one save, but he makes 2 saves there.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Steel, built to last, priced to sell. Hear it. Renovated Madison Square Garden as this 3-year project will near its completion this summer with the addition of a couple of sky bridges that will run just under the ceiling here, but an amazing transformation, and the Rangers and Knicks haven't missed a day. A project that cost close to $1 billion. Carl Hagelin drops it back to Callahan. His shot off the stick of Lyles and up and out of play.
Well, Gord, the benches are quite small, it seems, as it is right now. But there's a change in the coaching staffs right here. You see for Randy Carlisle on the bench, 4 coaches are on the bench. Dave Farish, Scott Gordon, Greg Cronin, and, of course, the head coach Randy Carlisle, as compared to Torts.
And Mike Sullivan.
Well, less congestion.
I thought there was a rule that said you could only have 3 coaches on the bench, but apparently not.
Cronin comes down for the 3rd.
And that bench also pretty short for Mikhail Grabowski, who has been parked on it for the better part of the last half hour to 45 minutes.
Well, he started the 3rd with the McClement line.
Yeah, and that's been about it. Kessel's long shot, gloved by Lundqvist, and he's got that one. 2-2 the score, 9:52 to go here in New York. We'll look out in the third period.
Well, Mikhail Grabowski has found himself on the 4th line. He played a season-low 10:39 in the last game against the Rangers, and he's just under 7 minutes in this game.
Yeah.
And now that it's a 2-2 game, when it was 2-1 for the Rangers, you saw early on, head coach Randy Carlisle had him on the ice, and now that it's a 2-2 game, I think he's going to go to the more defensive-minded players in this one here. We'll see if he gets some ice.
He's actually 4-0 on draws in the opening period.
Yeah. guy that's been great on the draw has been Bozak.
Now a centering pass from Van Riemsdyk, bounced away from him, and Callahan finds Brassard. And Derek Brassard's shot goes off the stick of O'Byrne and wide. 9.5 to go in the third period. Kessel collides here with Callahan, and now Van Riemsdyk has it for Toronto. James Van Riemsdyk fires on goal, Lundqvist knocks out over the blocker. And Brassard. Quickly ahead for Klo, and Ryan Klo tries to shovel that down. He and O'Byrne collide. And a rodeo move there by Klo to get his stick off O'Byrne. Now Klo battling for it again. And O'Byrne collides behind the Toronto goal. As Brad Richards reaches in for it. Richards has also been used sparingly in the last couple of periods for New York. Klo had that bounce off the heel of his stick. And the puck inside the Maple Leaf zone as now Kadri brings it. It got hooked from behind by Klo. Penalty coming to New York. And MacArthur got taken down as well, this time by Strahlman. And the Maple Leafs are going to have a power play with 8:32 to go in the third period.
Little reach out there by Klo through the neutral zone right there. And he gets a little bit of help from Kadri as well. Kadri kind of reaches out too, kind of gloves a little bit, pushes it aside, and the referee makes the call. Key power play here and a chance to go ahead for the Toronto Maple Leafs. The oldie's kind of hooking me, so I'll kind of glove a trick Gord a little bit.
Sure. But, you know, as coaching would look out, that's tipped into the Ranger bench by Phaneuf, who had a quick bit of eye contact with Tortorella. But as coaching will tell you, if you don't want to get called for that, don't put your stick in there.
Well, he actually apologized to the bench. Phaneuf did. But you're right. Yeah, you're right about that other part. You're right. Keep the stick down low and don't put yourself in that position.
Kessel, Bozak, and Van Riemsdyk all looking for that loose puck. And it's scooped up by the Rangers and fired down the ice by Derek Stepan. A lot of talk at last year's deadline, Darren, that Derek Stepan might be on the move for New York.
Well, that wouldn't have been a wise decision.
Now McDonough. That was the first round of Rick Nash discussions with Columbus. And now Stepan fires it down the ice.
You spend all that time, you draft, you develop, you give them an opportunity, and then you move players. I never thought that made a whole lot of sense.
It's New York, Darren. Kadri from MacArthur. Boyle got in the way of that. And puts it in. The chance now shorthanded for New York. Boyle with Darryl Powell. And MacArthur takes a whack at Boyle. The puck dribbles down in front. Powell on his knees. Couldn't get the puck to sit for him. And there's Grabowski at the tail end of the Toronto power play.
And the Leafs have given up four shorthanded goals against while the Rangers have scored four. Dangerous play there.
And here they come again. 3-on-2, Callahan, Boyle, and Delzato. Ryan Callahan sends it off the side of the goal. Bounce and puck it from Ryan. Oh, what a chance for Callahan. Oh. Couldn't get a shot away.
Oh, that's got some jump in the crowd now with those two chances.
Gunnarsson, popping with Callahan. Final seconds now, this power play. Kadri back for Gunnarsson. Carl Gunnarsson back to Nazem Kadri. Lyle, Gunnarsson, final seconds now. Gunnarsson feeds it down to Kadri, lots of traffic, shoots, blocked by Girardi, shovels it back in front, knocked away by McDonough, and Klo is back on the ice. Ryan Klo works in on Fraser. And now Gunnarsson shovels that ahead to Kessel. Squeeze that by Hagelin, and now Toronto can finish the chain.
Boy, Gord was boiling ever sour when he came to the bench, frustrated that he didn't capitalize. Two good shorthanded chances by the Rangers, led by Boyle.
Now Klo sends it back in front. Fraser knocked that away. And Phaneuf, to the line, but not out. Strahlman. Now Lord Hagelin sending a great chance. Wide on the save. But what a chance there for Richard.
What a save with the right pad.
And now from the line, a long shot goes wide from Strahlman. Great chances for the Rangers in the last 2 minutes, and the score remains tied at two.
That was a great read, though, by Ryan Murray. Pushes out with his left skate, gets to the top of the crease, and makes a wonderful save with that right pad.
Long pass tipped in by Komarov, and now McKenna takes a hard hit there from Leo Komarov, who rolled off and passed on the chance. Devils losing to Boston tonight. Rangers with a chance to take advantage and also move ahead of the idle Winnipeg Jets. Jay McClellan comes up back in front, and the pass bounced away from Gunnarsson back to Francis. To Jay McClellan, back to Cody Francis. Komarov fighting for space in front, bouncing puck in behind Lundqvist. And Komarov taking down. Under five to go now in the third period. Shots on goal are 24-20 in favor of New York. Now a bouncing puck for Boyle. And Boyle has it knocked away by Lyle. Boyle stays on it. Wraps it through the crease. Grabowski was taken down, and now Stepan on it. Eric Stepan banks it back to Delzato. Eminger a long shot, banks it off the inboard. Ripper on try, Reimers down, another great chance for Callahan. Delzato shoots off the line. Stepan fires, he put it high. All kinds of pressure now for the Rangers. And Grabowski can't squeeze that by Stepan. Now LeBurn can't get it out. Here's Stepan back with it. Sends it back in front out of the reach of Boyle. And the Leafs on their heels. Hamilton finally feeds it across to O'Byrne. He'll gain center ice. And Toronto will get a change.
Well, Grabowski had a chance to get that out on the far side and didn't late in the shift. It was a necessary time to be strong on it and make sure it gets out of the zone.
Calzano can't get it by Mozak. And now Delzato back with it. Looks ahead to Cole. Ryan Cole getting off the right side here in the third period. Hagelin. Feed it there to Richards. Down to Cole. Cole to Richards. He finds Hagelin. And Carl Hagelin shovels it back in front. Knocked down by Cody Franson. And then lifted up by Fraser. Now Hagelin back with it. Three to go in the third. Hagelin drops it back to Clow, and Kadri with it. 4-0. He offered a long drive and a hard one. Knocked up in the air by Lundqvist, up and out of play. Reimers shuts the door in the third, 2-2 the score.
Well, fake shot there by Callahan, and then to the front of the net. You see that Reimer holds his position and then gets a little help there from Gunnarsson, but this is the save here on Richards, right there. Richards gets inside of the D of the Leafs and gets a great scoring chance, and then there's Gunnarsson right on the doorstep.
Just a reminder, 4 days in April, Mike Weir's story coming up as soon as we're done here at Madison Square Garden, and you'll see it in its entirety. Off the faceoff win by Stepan, Michael Delzato with it. Ooh, high off the glass. Not much margin for error there. And Franson to Fraser. Looks in for Komarov, picked up by Callahan. In the step on, and Boyle. Long shot by Callahan, floats wide. Now Callahan, Delzato shoots, fire save. Loose puck in front, knocked away by McClellan. At the line, held by Strawman. He looks down for Callahan. And Ryan Callahan sends it back in front. Stepan could get a shot away. Grabowski with it for Toronto. And Mikhail Grabowski in across the line. Nifty move. Grabowski moves it right back into the wide.
What a bit burst of speed right there. Scrambling in their own zone. Randy Carlyle puts Grabowski back with McClement. Komarov, and then he gets an extra set of wheels right there.
Now Gunnarsson tied up by Zuccarello. And Matt Zuccarello got spun around by Gunnarsson. Won the battle for the puck, though. And Brassard turns it over to Gunnarsson. Van Riemsdyk lost the handle. And Girardi goes to McDonough. Dan Girardi's long pass. Kessel knocked it into the Toronto zone, and then Phaneuf swung it right back out. Gunnarsson to Bozak. Thanks to the head to Van Riemsdyk. And now knocked down by Girardi.
I know Van Riemsdyk's a skilled player, but his ability to chew on a mouth guard and still handle a puck is incredible.
Ryan Kolarov shot, gloved by Reimer, and he'll hang on with 1:07 to go in the third.
What? Well, Gabrowski does a good job of exiting the zone. His first priority was to get to the red line. Once the Rangers gave him the red line on a one-on-three, he had open space, open ice, and he took it. Had a chance to put the Leafs up by one with under 2 minutes to go at that particular point. So a great read there by Grabowski, using his speed and just hockey intelligence, as the Rangers must have just anticipated or thought that he was going to dump it in. Boy, did they give him a lot of space.
Off the faceoff win by Brad Richards, Delzato plays it back in, and Gunnarsson goes ahead to McClubbin. Kuhlman. Bumped there by Klo.
Kuhlman lost a glove. His left glove is on the ice.
By the way, the Devils have closed into a 4-2 game now against the Bruins after two periods. Komarov. Ian McClellan go to work in the final seconds now. The third period, and Delzato brings it ahead. Up ahead for Hagelin. Haven't seen a lot of Nash the last little bit for New York.
Nope, he's on the bench to the left, but you're right.
And Fraser ahead to Komarov. That's knocked down by Richards and fired back down to the Toronto zone as the Rangers will change. But this is once again Boyle with Callahan and Stepan. And Fedeau will let time expire. And the Rangers and Maple Leafs will go to overtime. And so both will get one. And the Rangers will break the tie with Winnipeg for the final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference. NHL on TSN Overtime is brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads. And speaking of that, let's show you the electric player of the game. Brought to you by Chevrolet.
And for Phil Kessel, boy, he had a myriad of great chances in the early going, was frustrated with it, but then he does capitalize with that quick stick right there to make it 1-0 unassisted. What a play by Van Riemsdyk as they take advantage of a fumbling play at the blue line by the New York Rangers. And Kessel finishes it off with his 14th goal. And Van Riemsdyk, with family and friends in attendance, gets a great helper. Wonderful job of protecting the puck and feathering that pass right over to the right-handed Kessel.
10 years ago, Mike Weir electrified Canada with a performance for the ages at Augusta National. Right after the game, don't miss 4 days in April, the Mike Weir story right here on TSN, and you'll see it in its entirety.
Well, you mentioned Rick Nash, and late in that period, we saw a lot of Boyle. Boyle's game really picked up, and we saw Boyle a lot with Stepan and Callahan on that top line. I looked over at one point just to make sure he was on the bench, but give Boyle credit. Boyle's game really picked up here in this third period. Moving his legs, driving hard to the net. He's hard to contain with the size that he is. And we already saw that in this game where the Leafs had to take a minor penalty trying to bring him down as he drove hard to the net. We'll see if Tortorella gets Nash on the ice, which he is right now, paired with Stepan on the 4-on-4 situation.
And Toronto with McClemmon and Kuhlman on the ice to defend. So there goes the overtime streak, Panger. Back-to-back days and it's over. And those three-point games are going to play a major role here in the final 2.5 weeks of the NHL regular season. In comes McClemmon with it. Shovel that wide of the goal as Delzato got a stick on him. Now Delzato goes back for Strahlman.
A great job by Jay McClement there. He just gets on the defensive side of it. Doesn't look like he's doing a whole lot, but he covers a lot of ice and doesn't even allow New York to get out of their zone.
Now comes Nash in stride between Fedeau, and a fluttering shot was knocked away by Reimer. Step up. Looks down low as Nash fights off Gunnarsson. Rangers are changing and Nash just owns the puck, plays it back to the line, but Girardi was late getting to it.
Yeah, Nash did look back and Stralman was bailing out of the zone, getting a change for Girardi.
In comes Callahan now. Along with Brassard, Ryan Callahan spins back, fires up through the crease. And Girardi on it. Plays it down to Brassard and down to Callahan.
Yes!
Callahan sends it back in front. Reimer steers that away. Bozak has a look and plays it up the center ice.
And Van Riemsdyk here to my right will jump on when Kessel gets off the ice. And there they go with this change.
Brassard to Callahan. And the captains collide just inside the Toronto line. And as the puck comes down to Van Riemsdyk, now he and Panuff had to avoid each other as Van Riemsdyk plays it across to Grabowski. And Mikhail Grabowski works his way and drops it back, intercepted by Brad Richards. Sends that rink wide. Now long shot, Stralman turned away by Reimer. As Anton Stralman had jumped in.
Oh, if that ends up going in the net, Grabowski's going to have a tough time bouncing back after that one. Just a bad turnover and a bad area of the ice for Grabowski.
Now Grabowski drops it back to Panuff, fights off Zuccarello. They collide once again in the corner. Panuff falls. Grabowski flies it back to Lyle. Van Riemsdyk to Lyle. Now Panuff is standing in front. Lyle shoots. Panuff spins, taking the puck to sit for him. And Lyles comes jumping in. John Michael Lyles fires. And the save is made by Henrik Lundqvist.
Well, Lundqvist, Gord, is reaching far to the left. And he almost got handcuffed there because John Michael Lyles fired it more into his body. Take a look at the goaltender lunging to his left. And you can see that Lundqvist has given him glove side, but it nearly catches him between the elbow and the side of the body. Lundqvist does a good job with all that paraphernalia he's got there of squeezing it tight.
Toronto controls off the draw. Cody Franson feeds across to Lyle. Tees it up. Lundqvist the save. And now Nash across to McDonough. Steve Emminger with it. Chips that into Stephon, goes looking for it, gliding hard with Franson. On the other side is Nash. Nash back with it. Walks out in front. Nash shoots. It's blocked by Franson. And Kadri's away along with MacArthur. Nazem Kadri crisscrossing with MacArthur. Trying to flip that across. Knocked down by McDonough. And quickly the Rangers counterattack. Stephon with Nash. Rick Nash winds his way in. Nash slides it in front. Rolling puck. And scooped up by MacArthur. Chance for a 3-on-1 for Toronto. MacArthur in front for Panuff. A bouncy puck well by Lundqvist. Rebound MacArthur. And look at Calgary. What a save by Lundqvist. Henrik Lundqvist saves the game for New York.
Holy jumping. It looked like Kadri had the wide open side on the blocker. What a save that is.
And now Belzamo back the other way. Callahan is rolling puck. Kessel can't knock it down. Great chance in front of Brassard. He couldn't find the puck. And Franson with it. A precious point at stake here at Madison Square Garden as Kessel comes in. Kessel with Lundqvist down. Now sends it back in front to Franson. Bozak with it. Callahan works his way in with Delzano, shoots. Reimer makes the easy save and dives out to pounce on the loose puck, and both teams have golden chances to end this game.
Yeah, both goaltenders strong, but none more brilliant than that save that Lundqvist makes. Typical of what he's done here in the with the New York Rangers. This one right there as he reaches out. He's got a defenseman in front of him. He should have had that one in his mitt. This wouldn't have happened if he had it in the big leather mitt. But he makes a great save on Kadri. Watch the blocker right here. How he sees it around McDonough is incredible. Great reactionary save there by Lundqvist. And Nash got away with one. A high stick in the far corner to the right of Reimer on John Michael Lyles. The bench of the Leafs were yelling and trying to get the attention of the official, but they just missed it.
Now Gunnarsson with it. And Panuff with 45 seconds to go in the period. Carl Gunnarsson in with Van Riemsdyk. And Grabowski, now the trainer Panuff. Steps around Brad Richards. Dion Panuff down low with it. Fidel spins, sends it back into a bouncing puck, is swatted away as Stralman got a piece of that. And now Grabowski back on it. Toronto making a change. Van Riemsdyk. Grabowski. He finds Lyles back in front. Van Riemsdyk between the feet. Grabowski spins and shoots. He put it wide.
Wow. Dipsy doodle there.
Now Grabowski back on it. A bouncing puck. And it's scooped up by Hagelin for the Rangers. Final seconds. Hagelin, long shot. That drifts high. And this game is going to a shootout. Lundqvist and Reimer tested so far, and they'll be tested again when we come back. And the New York Rangers in a battle for the final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference with a shootout coming up. And James Reimer and the Leafs really struggle at this portion of National Hockey League games. They're 0-4 this year. And one win in their last nine. You've got to go back more than a calendar year to find their last shootout win.
Well, he'll go Bozak, Kadri, and Grabowski in this one. But that end-to-end action late in this third period was outstanding. Just very entertaining. Good push to it in overtime, obviously, at 4-on-4. That's just an outstanding save right there. Outstanding save. And there's that stick by Nash. It just gets up there on Lyles. Kessel here, just sticks with it. Oh, uses his right skate as well on Brassard. Brassard thinks he might have a good golden opportunity there on the backhand. Randy Carlyle and Scott Gordon discuss things on the bench. There's a lot of walking, a lot of talking. He's trying to, Randy Carlyle at the break, really trying to keep his team focused here, getting into the shootout. Sullivan and Tortorella talking it over, as you'll have Nash, Zuccarello, and Callahan.
Tyler Bozak will shoot for Toronto. He's 3-for-4 this year. The rest of the Leafs combined, Aaron, are 0-for-17. And just a reminder that coming up as soon as we're done here, you will see in its entirety a tremendous documentary, 4 days in April, the story of Mike Weir's win at the 2003 Masters.
Well, he put Canada on his shoulders in a phenomenal event, huh? What a great man. Well, we know Nash has got a handful of bags of his trick. He can go backhand, forehand, he can turn, spin, you name it, he's got it.
All right, so the Rangers will go first, and it'll be Rick Nash. James Reimer's allowed 8 goals on 21 shots in the shootout this year, but hasn't received much goal-scoring support in the shootout. And in comes Rick Nash. On Reimer, no!
Good read by Reimer. Really good read. Large wingspan, trying to lure Reimer to his glove side. And if he can get him to the glove side a little bit more, then he might have him. But Reimer stays with him the whole way. Read it like a book. Great save.
So Bozak is 3-for-4 this year. The rest of the Leafs 0-for-17.
Now shooting for Toronto, number 42, Tyler Bozak.
Henrik Lundqvist is 3-3 in shootouts this year. Tyler Bozak. No.
I always found it was more difficult if you're going to go back to the between the legs move that you go to the backhand, forehand, backhand, and between the legs. And much like Reimer was on that first one, Lundqvist was right there.
Now shooting.
Matt Zuccarello has been good at this in his National Hockey League career. As round two begins, Zuccarello in on Reimer. Yes!
Well, before the game, that's what Tortorella was talking about when he was talking about Zuccarello. He said just he needs to define games with his offensive skill, and that means if we're in the shootout, he needs to score. You got a power play, he needs to get chances. Well, Zuccarello does it so right there, right between the wickets.
Kadri is 0-for-4 this year. Kadri with a chance to tie it. Nazem Kadri, oh, look, off the handle. And so now a chance for the Rangers to win it.
That's just a lot of shake and bake in tight right here. Stops, slows down, gives it a shoulder fake, and then just whiffs on it, trying to bring it from the forehand to the backhand, it looked like.
All right, the captain, Ryan Callahan, can end it right here. Callahan in.
Oh!
No! Great pad save by Reimer.
Boy, did he stretch out on that one. Just got his toe on it. Boy, I pulled my groin watching him do that. Are you kidding me? It looked like Allen had him there, and the knee was tucked in, the toe was tucked in, but he just exploded and pushed it out.
So now Grabowski has to score to extend the shootout. Grabowski in on Lundqvist. Mikhail Grabowski stuck, and the Rangers win it. New York Rangers win it by a score of 3-2. As Zuccarello scores the only goal in the shootout. Coming up right now on TSN, relive an iconic moment in Canadian sports history in celebration of the 10th anniversary of Mike Weir's historic Masters win. TSN presents 4 days in April, the Mike Weir story. That's coming up. So long from Madison Square Garden.